I would want invincibility. I would be unable to be destroyed. I would go to all those precincts and they would be clean the fuck out. I would come
hey,
and
hold up, hold up.
Someone hold them niggas up.
If you see
I had a superpower.
If you see an officer acting unlawfully, you can stop them. Are you a police officer? Miss
Well, who's talking? Oh, you're a miss. Okay, now keep your mouth shut. You're a miss. You're not doing shit. Keep your mouth shut. You see four cops ready to. You gonna go and run up on them? They will.
This is my point, though. This is my point, and you can hear me out, okay? Because this is my point. This is where I'm going with this, okay? And I do realize what you're saying because you got a lot of trigger happy cops, right? But when are we going to make the example at the moment of where we're not willing to allow you to kill us, right? And the reason I'm saying that is because I have two children. And if you think that you're going to take my child's life in front of me, and this is where I'm going with this. Say there were 30, 40 people, which there usually is a crowd. This type of stuff draws a crowd. And I'm saying, how does that crowd dominate that situation and let those officers know we are going to fuck you up if you don't? And did I just curse?
Yeah. You curse. Stop trying to not curse. Stop it. That was the best word for you. It was apropos.
I owe each of my children $5 now because of you. You have a okay, so I want to understand this. If we don't have the mentality as a people, because we've watched murder after murder after murder, if we don't freaking honestly, I don't care if you gotta wear a bulletproof vest, if we don't start freaking mobbing these police when they're doing stuff and just
that's different. Your child is different. That's true. That person just made a good point. That's your kid. You're going to go all out. But the reason why people don't do it is because they don't want to die. I understand that. They're watching and they're filming. I'm glad someone filmed it. Be happy someone filmed that shit. Thank God someone filmed it. Because you know what? Rushing it wouldn't have, if somebody bum rushed it, I think the whole situation would have changed. It would have been a different outcome. We wouldn't have these people going to jail. We wouldn't have all these fucking protests. This might be the tipping point right now.
I'm all about solutions. So my brain works different than people. I think, in my opinion, that we should police the police. And I feel that as a group, right, we have money. We know how to put money into things when we want it. We should fund groups like Black Gun Owners Associations, Black Panther type mentality, where they understand the law and that they are protecting us, but we are on the same page where we understand that, listen, until we set an example that you guys are going to act the same way you act in those white neighborhoods when you're making an arrest, the same way that you act when you're arresting someone who killed 9 people, right? You are not the judge. You are not the executioner. You are a cop who works for the executive branch of our government, and you don't have the right to take my life regardless of what you think I've done, right? And I feel that until we put our money into things that and stop calling the police on Black people all the time. Like, other Black people piss me off. They always calling the police on other Black people, and then you wonder why we're in the situation we are, because we use them to almost the same way, you know, you were talking about Karen, right? Karen the other day. on your video, and it really pisses me off when black people cannot be either civil to each other or don't deal with each other. Stop calling the police in our neighborhoods because they don't respect our neighborhoods. But then on the same token, treat your neighborhood and treat your neighbors with respect. And I'm just tired of watching us die on camera. I'm fed up with it. And I'm like literally learning how to use a gun at the gun range.
Like, my thing is this. Some people agree with you. Some people agree with me. I really don't care. I just know why some people talk a lot of shit unless they're in front of something. And a lot of times these cops are doing something. They know people are going to come at them. That's why the other cop was on the lookout. Like, what? You want to get blown away? You want to get blown away? That's why they have the other cops looking around like, wait, right. The fuck out of here. They're ready to shoot you.
Right.
Your color is their conditioned response. I think that some of these police places go kill niggas. I don't give a fuck what you do to them. White people, be careful. They train them. It's like, you know what it's like? Let me show you what it's like. They train these cops like the stoplight. Green, you go. Yellow, slow down. Red, you stop. And so you when you see those colors, you're like, boom. When you see the red, you stop. When you see a green, you go. We've been trained. And so when they see our complexion, black, kill them. White, you stop. It's literally like a stop sign. We're like a stoplight. We are treated like fucking stoplights. A stop, literally. Black, when you see brown, get them. You know, white, stop.
Right.
Yellow, Asian, slow down, wait, we'll see. And so with us, it's like automatic bang. We are like literally like stoplights. We are trained by color. And you know, when you drive, you know, have you ever seen when you drive, you get the green arrow, but it's not your arrow, but you think you gotta go. Because green automatically, you've done it so many times, green in your mind is go. So black in their mind is go, kill them. I don't give a fuck. Look at the way they're doing black women. They tackle black women, slam them against even if they're old, they don't like us. They don't like us, but as soon as when we start to prepare ourselves and we start, I'm talking about motherfuckers that are, because I'm telling you, this is what they're doing. I think they're waking up a sleeping giant and they don't even know what they're in for.
Yeah.
They're waking up a sleeping giant, because the problem with a lot of these motherfuckers is they're sticking their chest out, talking all this shit, but then I believe, this is what I believe, that there are organizations being formed of people that look like us, mm-hmm. and when the shit hits, it's going to hit, and these motherfuckers are going to be sorry they ever did this shit to us. That's what I feel. I don't know, but for some reason, I've been thinking like something is going to happen, and they're going to get, and remember, they're going by American numbers. They think they're the shit because they're not understanding about world numbers, because a lot of these fucking hillbilly backward fucks don't even know what's outside of their neighborhood. They don't know the international level of anger that's coming.
Mm-hmm.
They're not understanding.
Mm-hmm.
They're not getting it.
Right.
Because you already are afraid of us when you see us.
Right.
And we're not even mad and you're afraid. You're afraid of us when we just sit in there breathing, drinking coffee. You're upset because your horrible grandmother, your horrible grandfather, your fucked up uncles, your piece of shit cousins were telling you about niggas. Stay away from, stay away from, stay away from. And you, when you see us, you're fucking timid, real silly shit. But then they don't understand. This is when we're happy you're afraid.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But wait until you wake up everybody and we're ready to bust your fucking jaw.
Right.
Wait. And I'm telling you, I'm just saying that this is not some shit. This is not new shit anybody's discovering. Everybody should be feeling this.
Mm-hmm.
You're pushing us too much. This is this is almost, I think this might be the last straw right here. Like, right. And you think because you're the only one with, you think you're the only one prepared, but you don't even get it. You know, it's like when the escape, when slaves escaped, did they tell anybody? When slaves rebelled, did anybody know? No one knew. They were like, yeah, get over there. And right. All of a sudden, there was an uprising. They didn't know when it was going to happen. Harriet Tubman was like, I got this. They set it up. It probably took her months and years to go, it's going to take some time.
Yeah.
And we were, I'm trying to tell people, they act like, first of all, you know how many millions of black soldiers are trained? Mm-hmm. Do they know we fought in all the wars?
Right.
Do they know we fought in all the wars?
Right.
Do you know that we can shoot from 3,000 yards too? They didn't know? And we're faster than you. We're faster. We're fucking fast. You can even see by athletics, we are quicker. And then you want to fuck with us. But I'm saying this. This ain't coming from, and I don't want anybody like trying to misconstrue this shit, because that's what a lot of these motherfuckers do. Because a lot of times, the way white dudes get us is they'll trap like a one black kid or two black kids, and it'll be 10 of them. They always play unfair. They're always playing unfair. They never play fair, you know?
Yep.
So they're never like, oh, there's five white dudes and then there's five black dudes. Okay, let's do it. Let's do it. Now we can fight evenly. They never do that shit. They always go, let me beat up this 16-year-old black girl who's fighting, who's brave enough to fight. Like, black girls will fight. That's how, like, you're a grown-ass man with helmets and all that, and you got some little girl fighting. You're that much of a pussy that a girl with a sign is fighting you, let alone if it was a real motherfucker at you with the same strength as you, you know you would get your ass whooped. They're always, never one-on-one, always cheating. Yeah. Never one-on-one. They're never fucking with those ashy knuckle niggas that got knockout fucking numbers on them. They don't never fuck with them. They don't fuck with them niggas doing the push-ups in the fucking in the parking and you know in the park. Never one-on-one.
Yeah.
And you've seen some of the footage of some of the motherfuckers getting their asses handed to them, mm-hmm. trying to go hand to hand, and cats is wah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I'm just saying they love to do that. Because the Dominicans did it. The Dominicans that are angry that they have African ancestry, they were coming after, these black kids that were just protesting. All these Dominicans, like 30 of them, over four or five little black kids that were and they're blaming. And then the next day, some black people came over to check those dudes and said, what's good now? Mm-hmm. And then they go, oh, we good, we apologize. The real brothers came the next day and said, yo, I heard you was fucking with us. So when we wake up, when we get mad, now what? You see? So
you actually spoke to something also that we continue to do. As black people in this country, we continue to always want to include other people in our fight, right? And the reason I say that is because just like the point you made, you got Dominicans who are brutalizing Haitians in the DR, right? Who are discriminating against them often. They're so financially disadvantaged in Haiti because of the Dominicans, right? And so you have a group of, and I call it the brown people, that their only goal is to be accepted by whites because that gives them an advantage over us. And they're not, but that's why they do it. And understand the psychology, right? Because what do blacks always want to do? They say black and brown. Listen, this is my pet peeve about that. And I tell people this all the time. I don't care what you think. Brown people do not and have not suffered genocide in the United States for 400 years. Stop putting them on the same level with Black people. You should respect Black people for what they've contributed to this country and stop clumping us. They don't, they're not owed reparations in the way that Black people are owed. And you're diluting resources by doing so. People were very intentional with the people who they chose to hang in this country.
Yep.
And they were hanging brown people. They were hanging Black people. The people they're shooting on camera, the ones that they're preying on, right? Those are Black men and women, all right? Did you see the way Sandra Bland, when they brought her to the station and they had her handcuffed like a puppy and dragged her from the car into the station?
Yeah.
You know, a Black woman. All these videos have been of Black people. And I feel like at that point, until we understand that we're at such a disadvantage, we want so badly to be accepted, and we really need to stop doing that. Martin Luther King died because he said, I'm sorry, I delivered my people into a burning building. I really am sorry, right? Because he said,
yeah.
I'm going to get our check. His whole mindset changed because he understand that they don't respect anything except money and loss of life, right?
Yes.
And so intentionally, Black people, and I'm not talking about shades of Black, right? When I say brown, I'm talking about Hispanic cultures and things that people want to clump in as a minority. Talk about Black people, the same ones who you was discriminating against, who you wouldn't let in your colleges, the same ones that you were killing for being literate. They were Black people. That's what I mean when I say Black, right? Melanated Black people. You knew the difference then. Why are you trying to make it like we're a minority group now?
Yeah, fuck that people of color shit. Fuck all that.
People of color.
Yeah, they proven that they ain't down with us. Fuck all that shit.
Understand shades of Black and understand that we're
fuck all that. They proven that they ain't shit. Look, here's this dude. I want to show you this dude that went off. Oh, what silly people are clowning this motherfucker right now. Watch this. I'm gonna show you this dude right here.
I think I know what you're talking about.
You fucking going, you fucking bucks, you pieces of shit. Stop fucking cracking for these fucking fucking people. Say the fucking shit. What? Let the fucking jungle people kill themselves. Let the jungle people kill themselves.
Protect your neighborhood. Put your people first. And may God have mercy on them. If you are a fucking Dominican, want to be Black, you better not be saying that we're Black.
That's retarded. That's a retarded man.
First. Before them. Never put them first. Oh. This is what it comes down to. This is what it comes down to. Motherfuckers trying to follow up people.
He looked like a Black dude. That's what's hilarious. He looks Black.
Yeah.
You know what's hilarious? He looks Black. I thought he was a Black kid. He's spitting and his teeth are fucked up. He needs to come to your office. Dude, he was like this.
Hey, you know what?
That's what it sounded like.
People are so miseducated that they don't even understand their culture and how their African ancestry. So like I don't care. Like honestly, this is my thing. Like, if you know me, just to know me, like, I really don't care. You can spend your money. You can do whatever you want to do. But people who I associate with, they think the same way that I do. And so him, I laugh at him because.
Dude, he sounded, he really sounded like he had a, he really, had like he had a mental deficiency. Yes. But a lot of times, a lot of these, and I'm not trying to be mean, a lot of them don't, you ask them for a high school diploma, don't think you're going to get one. A lot of them are kind of, and it's like, he was really, really like his brain was short circuiting.
He needs to figure out that he was
mentally disabled, and he didn't even get to say what he wanted because his brain was like, we're gonna mess with your speech. Like his left side of his brain just kind of just, he was foaming at the mouth. It was really, very, very, that was like very, like you're like at a mental hospital and you gotta wait to sedate him. Like, okay, all right, here's your medicine. There we go. Okay. There you go. Fuck.
It's people like that. Like I said, at the end of the day, I don't care. Throw them out. I could care less. Like what someone like him says, I hate to see that, especially when in the end of the day, if something were to go down, if someone called the police on him, he'll realize in that moment, right?
With that nappy ass hair he had. It's hilarious. He had all this nappy ass hair. I thought he was a black dude. And I'm thinking, oh, is he talking about, oh, don't say black again. And he's angry because his hair's all furry.
Yeah.
And he's like, damn, this guy, I was going to show, man, Billy Porter, he really disappointed me. Watch this. You know Billy Porter, right?
Hey, hold on. Let me see.
The black people here. Because y'all ain't gonna like this one.
Ugh.
As a queer man in America, my basic human rights have been up for legislation every single day that I have had breath in my body from all sides. And by that, I mean that the black community's relationship with the LGBTQ plus community is appalling at best and eerily similar to that of white supremacists.
Oh, what a fucking idiot.
Hear me, black people, and hear me well. I'm calling y'all out right here and right now. You cannot expect our demands of equality to be met with any real legislative policy and change when y'all turn around and inflict the same kind of hate and oppression on us.
Who paid this Negro? Who paid this Negro? Who paid this Negro? Who paid him?
I don't know.
He is a foolish gay dude. And he thought that his, you're still a dumb motherfucker. And they should have said dumb as fuck. What was that? You literally are watching black people die on camera and you got the nerve to say this. Oh, you know who added it was Tariq Nasheed. He said, the white LGBT community has pushed their mascot, Billy Porter, who is the LGBT Candace Owens, out to spew their anti-black racism for them.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So listen, the saddest part,
disagree with him on all levels. That was really dumb. Who paid you, nigga? Who paid you? Who paid you, nigga? Because that's what you are in the gay community is a nigga. Because they're very racist in the gay community. You dumb motherfucker.
Right. So.
What was that?
What's interesting.
Who's playing these butter biscuit eating niggas? He was dancing for a butter biscuit.
What's interesting is, like, gay people, they go hard, but they get it, right? So they bought politics. That's why you had Obama passed 3 laws for homosexuals, right? Because they buy politics. And that's what I was talking about earlier with like Powernomics. And when you talk about like Dr. Claude Anderson, and he talked about that on the level of where first he broke it down. First it was economics, right? And building black businesses, because that's where your power is. And then buying politics, right? And not voting either Democratic or Republican, but voting as a